Anonymous threads turn a teenage dream into a nightmare now on Carlton in episode 2 of Night and Day.
Happy birthday.
She looks nothing like me.
We should do something.
I mean, the kids are having a party, why shouldn't we?
Ernie Hester, talent scout for Newcastle United.
I've been thinking about our situation. Maybe now would be a good time to get married.
We could relive that night of passion we had 16 years ago.
I wonder where that got us.
I can't. Now it's leaving.
You're a great kid.
Why do I feel a butt coming on?
It's a problem. You're just a kid. This has got to stop.
I'll be the one who decides when it's got to stop. Remember, I've got nothing to lose. You have.
Bunking off work again, though?
Oh, it wasn't busy, so Kaz, let me pop out, get some stuff for the party.
I thought your dad was sorting that.
Did you take sugar, Mr. Wells?
No.
Sweet enough already, eh?
Actually, Jane, I'll skip the tea. I've only got an hour.
Oh, that's a shame. I was hoping to speak to you both about something. It's about Della.
What about her?
Do you think she feels special?
What?
It's just a feeling. You know those feelings, Miss Doyle. There's a necklace in the market. She didn't want to ask you, thought you wouldn't be able to afford it.
Oh, well, I'll go and get it. You couldn't show me, could you, Jane? I don't want to make you late getting back to school.
No problem.
I'll get it. But you've got to get back to work. We don't want you getting the sack. Not now we've got a daughter with such expensive tastes.
Is that all right, Jane?
It's my pleasure.
Cheers.
What can I get you?
G&T. Double.
A bit early for you being drinking, innit?
It's not every day your daughter turns 16. Oh, thanks, Charlie.
You know, there was a time you didn't mind calling me Dad. Or Pop. Or Father.
Yeah, well, times change.
Ever at that age. I remember your 16th. Miserable as sin you were.
I did have reason.
Was that? That year? Things you forget, eh?
You miss her.
Your mum was one of a kind. Stubborn, argumentative, and a terrible cook. Every day.
Hello, Roxanne. And how's my beautiful stepdaughter today?
I'm good, thanks, Donna.
You must feel so old, having a daughter that age.
I think I'll be off.
Hey, you haven't finished your drink.
Oh, right. Oh. Thanks, Jolly.
You really thought I was going to tell Roxanne about us, didn't you?
No.
It's okay. A little mistrust in a relationship's always good. Do you love me?
Come on, Jane.
Because I don't love you. In fact, I don't know why I ever got involved with you. Do you know, in less than 3 hours, we could be in Paris. Or Rome. Why not?
Because my life's here.
Can you at least let me try and change your mind?
Hey. I don't see how you've got time to be looking at girls, Sam.
Oh, give us a break, Luce.
Me give you a break? What about the washing up that's been sitting in the kitchen?
I'm doing my best, Lucy.
I'll say you are, making me spend a night with the Adams family. You might as well have sent me to that woman.
What woman?
Aunt Rachel.
Oh, come on, Luce, they're not that bad.
So, how much of our housekeeping money did you and Mandy spend last night?
I don't have to ask your permission for everything.
It's not like we're ever going to be able to afford anything anyway. You're never going to make it as a footballer, Sam. It's never going to happen.
You just missed Della. Now I'm getting a bit old to get picked up, aren't I? You're right, Mum.
Am I a good parent?
No.
No, I'm serious. I know things haven't always exactly been ideal, but I've always tried to do my best for you. You know that, don't you?
Well, you're a better parent than some people I could mention.
He is trying.
Yeah, very. I'm sorry, Mum, I just don't trust him. I mean, Della might think he's perfect, but I know what he's done. You told me. Like, what's to stop him doing it again?
I'm pregnant. I know, don't remind me. I spent a lifetime lecturing you and Della on the virtues of safe sex, and then something like this happens. I mean, how stupid do you think that makes me feel now?
Have you told Alex?
No.
Well, why not? Well, he won't hear it from me. Some really weird news.
What's up?
Well, I mean, I'm not supposed to say, but Mum's pregnant again.
But that's great, isn't it? What?
Not like the world needs another mini Alex Wells.
Do you think you'll ever get on with that guy?
I suppose. I mean, why should I? It's not as though he's my real dad.
But, you know, he's made sacrifices and stuff.
You've got to stop hanging around with the birds, mate. You're starting to sound like one.
Oh, Jay. How's it going?
Hi, Jay.
Nice top, Dennis. Is that one of your dad's?
He's not my dad. He's...
You're so easy to wind up.
Right, yeah. Well, I'll see you later at yours.
Later. See you later. Oh.
I was just on my way home, and I thought I'd give you one last chance to wish me happy birthday.
Oh, I'm sorry. You know, Lucy's been ill, and I just totally forgot.
Don't worry about it. And I thought I should warn you that I think Della's got the teeniest of crushes on you.
Ah. Right.
Break a heart and I'll smash your face.
I won't. Hang on. Hello? Mandy. I just lost your number.
You're right, Jane.
Just because you're my creepy cousin doesn't mean we actually have to talk to each other.
Oh, yes. Because talking to people, that'd be so weird.
Frankie, what do you see when you look in the mirror at the end of the day? This sexy, confident woman? Or this terrified little girl who thinks she knows everything but hasn't got a clue about anything? Flat shoes, flat chest, flat life.
Thank you.
Alex Wells Construction.
It's the idea of a joke.
Jane?
So we're not laughing.
What are you talking about?
The message.
What message?
The message you just sent me.
I haven't sent you any message. And if you use this number... Jane?
You two still pretending to be deaf? Has someone gone out?
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
Come for the jumble. Come in. I hope you've got a big car with you. I've got a whole heap of stuff here for you.
Actually, I haven't come about the jumble.
Are you Jennifer Taylor?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Roxanne Doyle. You had an affair with my partner 8 years ago. How many times I stood outside that front door just trying to pluck up the courage to ring the bell. I wrote your letter. Several, in fact, never sent them. I suppose I just wanted to know what the opposition looked like.
And then it must be a relief to find out that it looks like this.
No.
Look, you don't have to humour me. Whatever Alex saw in me when he had you sitting at home, I don't know.
Why do you think he did it?
Look, Alex and I only met a couple of times and it wasn't exactly a brief encounter then. If it's answers you want, then you're really asking the wrong person.
Vicky Rockingham. Social services.
I didn't realise we had an appointment today.
Didn't I tell you?
Oh, sorry, it must have slipped my mind.
Well, you're the phone company. You must be able to trace who sent it. Yeah, thanks for nothing.
Mum says you better slap your polyfiller on, they'll be here in a minute.
Who?
Della and the rest of those sad freaks she calls family.
I suppose you think this is funny. Well, I've got news for you, little brother. It's going to take more than that to scare me.
So, how are we doing?
You tell me.
Everything's fine, isn't it, Luce?
Yes, it's wonderful. I've never been happier.
So you two are getting along okay? Not too many rows, I hope?
No. I love my big brother. He's the best. Only problem is, he won't let me smoke in the house. I have to go outside. Do you have a light?
Ah, just opened a bottle of the old Vino Collapso.
Ah, beer will be fine, thanks, Duncan.
Sure. Dennis?
Cheers. I'll get it.
Right. I called into the salon. Cass said you'd been gone all afternoon. Do you want to tell me what's going on?
No.
So, how are you two then?
Great. Sorry, I'm late meeting.
Oh, you're not at all.
Hello, love. How's your day?
Yeah, great.
No, you won't be wanting this then.
It's gorgeous. But you can't afford this.
You're only 16 once.
Thanks, Dad.
I was watching that.
Well, you're not now, and in fact, I don't think you'd be watching it for a very long time.
It served you right, Sam.
This isn't a game, Lucy. You mess around like that again, they'll send you to a home.
Well, that's what you want, isn't it?
Go to your room.
Well, I'm really scared.
I said go to your room.
I was going anyway.
And if you think you're going to Jane and Della's party tonight, you can forget it.
I hate you. And I'll never love you like Mummy and Daddy. Ever.
Do you like it?
Yeah, looks fine. A little cheap, maybe.
Really?
Hey, this is better than this monstrosity.
You don't like that? That's so gorgeous.
It would look better on you. I mean, with that dress of mine. You wouldn't by chance be on the pool tonight, would you, Della?
You think it's too much?
He'll love it.
What do you mean?
Sam. I'm right, aren't I? Look, all you have to do is go up to him and whisper in his ear, is it hot in here? Or is it just you?
That is definitely the worst chat up line I've ever heard.
Always works.
You want to swap?
Can't you go to Manchester tomorrow morning?
The meeting's first thing. Anyway, the plane's not till 9. You know, I'm staying for dinner.
Hi. Oh, oh, hi, I'm Mike.
Hi.
You're right.
Hiya.
Hiya. Bit of fluff.
Oh, right, thanks.
Now, look, are you sure you two aren't going to stay? I mean, there's plenty to go around, isn't there?
Oh, sure.
No, can't stop. Just thought I'd drop these off. Anyway, where's my favourite niece?
Upstairs.
Oh, I'll go get her.
I'm offering the chance of a lifetime. It's a chance that only comes around once.
All right, to come in.
Only if you've got a present.
No. Your uncle's downstairs.
Are they staying for dinner too?
No.
You want to give me a hand with this?
Sure.
Do you ever get that feeling, Dennis, that something's going to happen?
Sometimes.
But it's not for the best. It's not a good feeling. Something you can't control.
You better finish getting dressed.
Roxy, what's wrong?
I went to see Jennifer Taylor today.
You're kidding. Why? Why now?
Because I don't know. I know I've said I've forgiven Alex and everything, but it's just... It's hard, so...
Oh, come here. Look, that was 8 years ago, and you've moved on since then. Come on. Don't let it spoil your daughter's 16th.
You're right.
What was she like?
Nice.
Oh, I hate that.
Samuel. Yeah, it has been a long time. How are you doing? Look, can I come over?
I want to talk to you about something. It's something you might be interested in. It's about Lucy and Ben.
No, yeah, something more important than going around to see a bloke's ex-mistress.
Pregnant.
What? Why didn't you tell me?
Oh, because I wasn't sure. Oh, man, I'm sorry.
Oh, forget it. You always were a secretive cow. When are you going to put him out of his misery?
I thought I might just let him sweat a while longer.
Mm-hmm. All right, you two.
Thank you.
find out more about Night and Day, log on to itv.com/nightanddaye.